Hello, this is Dr. Christy Patton-Lokes, a chemical engineering professor at Missouri S&T. This video is going to be on liquefaction, and it is being produced for the course Chemical Engineering 5220, Intermediate Thermodynamics. Our goal in this lesson is that by the end, you should be able to draw and analyze a series of simple steady-state components that can change a gas product into a liquid without using refrigeration. This is a very simple liquefaction process. In this, we bring in a gas, we compress it to a higher pressure, and then cool that. This cooler, higher pressure material now is going to be sent through a throttling valve, where the pressure is going to drop and provide a two-phase system that will be sent to a flash drum where we can separate off the gas and the liquefied gas. The liquefied gas is our desired product. The remaining gas is waste as far as this process is considered. If we look at each one of these steps, the compressor, steps 1 to 2, a compressor is going to increase the pressure of the gas from P1 to P2. Ideally, it's isentropic, but in reality, we're going to have an isentropic efficiency that's going to be something less than 1. Typically, it will be adiabatic, and if you look at the energy balance for this system, then the power required to operate this is going to be the mass flow rate times the change in enthalpy from the outlet to the inlet. This should give an answer that is going to be positive, indicating that energy is being added into the process through this work. The second steps, 2 to 3, is a cooler. This is going to decrease the temperature of a gas from T2 to T3. Now, no work will be done here. There are no moving parts. So an energy balance results in Q, the rate of heat transfer, is the mass flow rate times H3 minus H2. This should be negative, meaning that heat leaves the process. 3 to 4 is a throttling valve. This decreases the pressure of the gas from P3 to P4. Typically, these are adiabatic. They have no moving parts, and so therefore work can be considered to be zero. If you also have something fairly small, then you're going to have no change in kinetic or potential energy. You end up with a mass balance, or an energy balance rather, that says that H3 equals H4. And finally, we're going to separate the two phases that have been formed. So we send it to a flash drum. This is going to just use gravity to let the liquid drop to the bottom and be removed via pipe, and the gas can be free to leave out of the top of the flash drum. An energy balance can be used on this two-phase system to determine what the mass is of each of the two phases that are formed. The mass times enthalpy coming in will equal the mass times enthalpy of the two stages that, or two streams, excuse me, that leave. We can improve this process. The Lindy liquefaction process is a very commonly used one. And what this is going to do is take that waste gas and recycle it so that it never leaves. We're not going to have a waste product in this way. In order to do this, we're going to use a heat exchanger that's going to be used to complete the cooling of the material coming from the cooler into the throttling valve. And by doing that, it's also going to take advantage of some of that excess energy we've added to our gas before it goes back into the compressor. So the advantage of this is that there's no waste and we have reduced cooling demand on our cooler. This is going to be accomplished in the heat exchanger. We have not done the balance on this, but a heat exchanger, the heat transfer from one stream, labeled here as 5 to 5 prime, is going to be the amount of heat that then is going to be removed from the stream 3 to 3 prime. So all I need to do is calculate the heat transfer in one stream, and that's going to be the opposite sign heat transfer of the other stream. So this concludes our lesson on the Lindy liquefaction process. Thank you.